Hi, this is Terri White. Welcome to my YouTube channel. Thank you for subscribing and being a part of our discussion platform. As always, I want to encourage you to log on and give us some discussion topics that you would like to know about, or some things that you, questions that you may have that you would like for me to answer or talk about on our YouTube channel. If you are a professional or a minister and you would like to join me in some of the discussions, I welcome that as well. Today, we're going to talk about when is it time for your teenager to go to therapy? And we're going to talk about three different criterias or three major issues that to help you determine that it is time for you to seek therapy for your teenager. So how many parents are out there say, oh, they're just acting like regular teenagers, you know, I'm not, you know, concerned about their behavior, or, you know, something's really wrong with my child and I need to get them to therapy, and maybe it's just that their grades are declining. So today we're going to discuss these three very, very important points to help you determine that it is time for your teenager to go to therapy. So the first point I want to talk about is when boundaries are being broken consistently, not just a one-time deal, but this is like an ongoing basis. Your teenager is constantly breaking boundaries. So when I'm talking about boundaries, what I mean is that maybe you and your spouse have a, you know, curfew time set up, or you have specific rules that is expected for your teenage to follow. Rules such as maybe that they have to clean their room, rules like they can't have company coming over, or there's certain things that they have to do at a certain time. So when your teenager is constantly breaking these rules and you're finding yourself disciplining them all the time and they're not responding appropriately to discipline, that's an indicator that something else is going wrong, right? So when we're talking about consequences, something to keep in mind is that the consequence needs to fit whatever it is, the behaviors that's happening. So if you have a child that maybe is breaking curfew and the curfew is like at 11 o'clock or 12 o'clock at night, and you say to them, you know, I'm going to take your car keys because you are not coming home when you're supposed to come home, that's an appropriate consequence for that type of behavior. But if you have a child that's not cleaning their room and you're saying, I'm going to take your car keys because you didn't clean your room, that behavior doesn't fit that particular consequence. So you might want to sit down and look at, okay, what kind of consequences are we going to have for these type of rules or these type of boundaries that are being broken? So again, we're talking about the first thing is when your child is breaking boundaries or they're not being respectful of the boundaries for you and your spouse in the household rules. And your child is not following household rules. So household rules being things like no company over when we're not home. A household rule may be that they have certain time that they have household responsibilities or chores. Those are what we call household rules and responsibilities. So if your child is not following those rules and you're constantly, again, having to discipline them, or it is starting to now impede on the family relationship, that's an indicator that there's something else going on and we need to seek further help, okay? The second indicator is when the child starts to have academic problems or issues at school. So when I'm talking about issues at school is when you notice that their grades are declining, you notice that you're starting to get phone calls from teachers or the assistant principal, there's starting to be issues with disciplinary actions at school, they're skipping class. Those are all issues within the school setting, and this is an indicator that something's going on that you need to address. Who is it that they're around at school? You need to explore their friends and who they're hanging around. What type of influences are they having that's causing them to start breaking rules and having issues at school? So the third indicator is when it starts to impair the family. When your teenager's behavior starts to spill over into the family and impair the whole family system, it's now becoming a problem that you need to seek help. maybe the child's behavior is starting to have a negative impact on other siblings in the house. Maybe it's starting to cause more conflict within your relationship with your partner. Or maybe it's where the police is having to come out to the house. Or there's issues with the homeowners association. Anything that's happening around the family or with family members is an indicator that your child is starting to need help. So we want to talk about the frequency and how long these situations are happening when they're happening. So frequency is if you have a combination of these things that are happening a few times through the week, that's probably a bit much, okay? And that means that we need to start seeking help. If you're noticing that, you know, they're not just skipping class, but maybe it's a combination of skipping class for three or four periods throughout the school day, and you're having family issues within the family system and they're lasting a pretty long time, those are indicators that it's time to seek help for your child and the family. And when I'm talking about duration, sometimes you can have issues in the family and you can clean it up pretty quick, or you can resolve the conflict pretty quick. It's not something that, you know, takes a couple of days to fix or repair. But if it's starting to be where it's taking a couple of days to get through, or it's spilling over throughout the day, then that means it's a little bit intense. It's a little bit much. So your family may need some help in resolving these conflicts. So again today, just to kind of sum it up, we talked about three indicators that it is time to get therapy for your teenager due to their behavior. First one is boundaries being broken. The second one is that their behavior is starting to impede on their school. And their third one is the family system is now starting to be dysfunctional. So thank you for joining me. Again, please stay tuned as we have more videos that we are going to be posting and more discussions coming up. Thank you.